Dear all, good morning to everyone. I think you all are keeping good at your home. Even then, you have to take care of your health, follow the instruction of COVID-19. Dear children of standard 10th A, let us start lesson number 20. Social problems and challenges. It is a last lesson of your textbook. We can have this lesson for our teaching today. As you know, India is the largest democratic country in the world. Likewise, India is the largest populous nation after China in the world. We follow different religion, we believe in different religion, we speak different languages, our custom, tradition, each and everything in the country is different. So many diversities are there in our country. But these diversities, most of them are created because of the inherent issues of our nation. We have a population, as I told you, second largest popular country in the world. Most of the issues are created by our population. We have problem of unemployment, poverty, illiteracy, inflation. Likewise, we have the problem of casteism due to different religion, communalism, and corruption. Except it also, we face the problem of terrorism and also natural calamities nowadays it happens in our country. Most of this topic we have discussed in the previous lessons. Today, our discussion is about communalism and casteism. It is one of the important features of our country that we all believe in different religion. From the religion, different castes were created so that casteism is existing in our country. Of course, diversities were not a matter when we fought against the enemy of our nation. We fought bravely, we unitedly stood and drove away the British people from our country. That is the reason we enjoy freedom today. But there is an issue. In the free India, our nation's existence in peril, danger, because of the development due to changes. Our society is going towards changes. These changes create socio-economic and political issues. We have to think about it. As I told you, most of the issues we discussed in the classes which we studied earlier. Today we are going to discuss about some of the other issues. We are talking about communalism. What is communalism? It is also a question for you. What does communalism mean and how can we solve the problem of communalism? Communalism means, you know, religion is a matter of faith. We all believe in different religion and so many religions are also there in our country. That is a peculiarity of our nation. Communalism means those who believe in a particular religion, those who follow a particular religion, they give excessive importance to their religion and showing superiority over other religion. We are considering other religion as inferior. You know, in our country, all religion are equal. No one can show any superiority over any other religion. We cannot consider any religion as inferior, or we cannot say that some religion is such and such a inferior one. In the constitution, it is written, India is a socialist, sovereign, secular democratic republic. Secularism, you know, communalism, regional feeling, These all are against the interest of our constitution. We are breaking the rules of the constitution when we do it. So once more we can go to see the point. What does communalism mean? When a group of people of religion or sect oppose the religion or sect because of any reason, communal tension arises. When we show superiority of our religion on others, it will lead to problem and clashes and riot. We know small issues are enough in India for creating communalism and a feeling of hatred. There are some people who create hatred in India. Nowadays it's the time of social media. You know, we can make a small clip regarding any matter religious, and if we send it out, people will spread everywhere. It can create a communal tension, fight. Finally, it will lead to riot in the country. Our country is also known for communal riot. Delhi, recently also there was riot. Most of the cities, it is there. And this we have to control. It is a must. So, you have got some point about communalism. When a group of people of religion or sect oppose the other religion because of some reason and considering that religion as inferior and create tension, chaos, riot, etc. in the society. This is called communalism. We all discussed communalism and how it create a problem in the society and its impact on our economy and the life of people. Let us discuss how can this issue be solved. How can communalism can be eradicated from our society? First is that there must be a strong government. That government should take punitive action against those who create a problem in the society. Communal element, people who spread communalism in the society, they should be dealt with maximum force. You know, government has defense force, paramilitary forces, and other agencies, police, all use their power to control it. Corona time, we implemented curfew. People were asked to stay at home. They followed it the same way. Such a law should be implemented properly to deal with. So, one step. Second, mass media. Media plays an important role in the maintenance of peace and harmony in the society. You know, we all belongs to different communities, religions and on. TV presentation, program when they present, they should present a program that can create a communal harmony and a fellowship among people. You know, various festivals are there. When festival comes, each religion's festival should be given important and never spread the news that flare up communal riot, communal unrest. It is a duty. You know, TV can also play, newspapers can also play. It comes in the printed media. Again, education. Education is very important. Ignorance happens because of lack of education. Religion teaches, all the religion teaches to love our brothers, help each other, live together as community. But some community people make this opportunity for what? Creating trouble in the society. So we have to beware about all this. Again, we have to think about education. We are continuing with that topic. Education, we are conducting prayer songs in the school. When we conduct prayers in the school, we can include prayer songs of all religion. Then children will feel that they are respected, they are considered. That is another point. Again, you know, political parties. There are some political parties in the country which has religious background. Political parties with religious background should not be given any recognition. They should not be allowed to contest or set their candidate in the election. So it can also be, now you know, religion is a good thing to gather people. If religious matters are spoken, people will get it together. It should be stopped. Again, religious leaders, you know, religious leaders, we all follow the instruction, advice of religious leaders. They should think that they are serving the society. Never give speech, oration, anything when it affects the interest of the society. We should create a communal harmony among the people, such as speech only given by religious leaders. There must be good friendship among religious leaders belonging to various religions. Above and all, we have to think that all are our friend, all are our human being. Religion teaches, we should think about the talking of Swamiji, Swami Vivekananda. Service to people means service to God. That good idea we have to implement. We have to consider our friend as our fellow human being. Humanism should be developed. Friendship, all should be developed so that people will love each other. We can have a community where all live together in fellowship and harmony. Let us stop our class here. We can have another topic with another day. Thank you.